In this video, we are going to introduce to the differential kinematics analysis. This kinematics differential analysis is going to include the velocities and the acceleration analysis. Let's start with the velocity analysis. Velocity analysis, the objective is to establish the mathematical relationship between the joint velocities and end effector velocities. The mathematical tool that is, we are going to use is the so-called Jacobian or Jacobian matrix. That's a powerful tool in order that depends on the robotic configuration. So for a mathematical concept for this Jacobian matrix, suppose that we have n equations, n independent equations that come from the forward kinematics analysis, and then using these differentiation rules is possible to transform these derivatives of these functions using a partial derivative of this function and then multiply by the temporal derivative of the joint variables that we have in any system. So at the end, as we can see here, this partial derivatives, these functions, is going to represent a direct relationship between the m coordinates, derivatives with these m coordinates, with respect to the derivatives of these joint variables. So this size of this matrix is going to depend on the numbers that you have of these m and n numbers. Now, similar to the forward and inverse analysis, we have a direct and inverse velocity analysis. In direct velocity, we use a direct Jacobian matrix. In this case, you receive as information the joint velocity, and then you are going to find the end effector velocities. Using these diagram blocks, you can see that in this case, that is the input, so you receive the joint velocities, and the Jacobian matrix is going to use it to find these end effector velocities. In other hands, the inverse velocity, you receive as an input the end effector velocities, and then the inverse Jacobian matrix is used to find the joint velocities. If and only if this Jacobian matrix is a square matrix. So for direct velocity, assuming we have an n degree of freedom robot, the Jacobian matrix is going to mapping this relationship between the joint space velocities and the end effector velocities. And this is the mathematical representation. So this Jacobian matrix depends on the robot configuration, and then is multiplied by the given joint velocities, and then you obtain the end effector velocities. Assuming that, as an example, we have the same numbers of n coordinates for these end effector velocities, and also we have the n joint variables. So the Jacobian matrix, the size of this matrix is going to be an n by n matrix. And then you are going to have this matrix, a 6 by 6 matrix, that any of these components is going to represent these partial derivatives of any of these functions with respect to any of these joint variables. On the other hand, the inverse velocity, in this case, the objective is to determine is possible to find a solution for the joint velocities given the end effector velocities. And then, similar to the four inverse kinematics analysis for position, we have three cases. The first case is when we have the same value for m and n number. So, is this the case? So the inverse velocity is possible to obtain using the inverse Jacobian matrix. But it depends if it's possible to obtain this inverse Jacobian matrix. For the second case, is when you don't have enough numbers of degrees of freedoms, and then you don't have a solution for this problem. It's possible that you don't have a solution for this problem. And the last case is when you have more degrees of freedom for the robot, and then you are in a redundant robot, and then it's possible to find an infinite solutions. So another study that is very important to include when we analyze the velocity is the singularity analysis. So a singular configuration for this robot is related when the Jacobian matrix, the determinant of the Jacobian matrix, is equal to zero. And then when we equals this determinant to zero, it implies that there is no inverse matrix for this Jacobian matrix. And then in Patrix, we can see that when you have this mathematical value, is when you going to lose one or more degrees of freedom, and also you reach high values of speed. These singularities are possible to classify as when you are very close to the limits of the world space, or when you align two or more links of one robot. In industrial application, these singularities are very important because at the end you need to reduce or eliminate from your joint motions. Now, the last topic for this video is the redundancy. Redundancy is something that is very common in industrial robots. So you have more degrees of freedom than required to move the N effector to a specific position. So it's the case when you have N bigger than N. So in this case, you have an infinite number of configurations that makes possible to reach this N effector position. The Jacobian is a nonce square matrix. And then you need another tools, mathematical tools, to solve the inverse velocity problem. However, redundancy is also a study very important in robotics because they give you opportunities to apply different configurations that you can find using this redundancy in your robot.